Hello, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, wherever you are. Hopefully everyone is doing fantastic. Today we are going to learn basics of Selenium automation using Java. So we will be automating a simple scenario using Selenium WebDriver and Java language. So let me give you the topics those we are going to cover today. So we are going to install Java and Eclipse and run a Java code. And then we are going to download Eclipse, Selenium libraries, and we'll associate those libraries with a project. And then finally, we'll write code to automate this test case. You can see the steps that we have in the test case. So to do that, we are going to follow this document for the installation process. First of all, for Selenium, you need to make sure that you have Java installed, as we are going to do Selenium using Java. So you can do Selenium using Java, Ruby, Python, or C#, but Java is the most popular language for Selenium automation testing. So how you make sure that if you have Java installed in your computer or not? So you need to go to your start menu and type cmd to go to command prompt. And once you are in command prompt, you will be typing this command Java. And if you see Java is not recognized as an internal or external command, that means you don't have Java installed in your computer. So as you can see, I do not have Java installed. So what I'll have to do, I'll have to install Java, right? So yeah, let's move forward. So to install Java, you will have to download Java from Oracle site. So to download it, you can go to any browser and you can type, let's say, download Java, right? It will take you to the page, and from here you need to select Oracle. You need to look at this thing, oracle.com, to download it. But for me, I have my URL. I'm going to download it by using my URL. So I'm going to copy this URL and paste it in the browser. So let me go there and paste it here, and it should take me to the expected place. So as you can see here, we have JDK 11 and different other versions. We are going to go to install JDK 8 basically, because some of you might have older computers where you have 32-bit operating system. Some of you might have, you know, latest computer. But for me, I'm going to download JDK 8, and that is what I'll be getting here. Can you see JDK 8 download? So, and if you go to JDK 8 download, right, you will see that JDK 8 has 32-bit and 64-bit. JDK 8 is suitable for both 32-bit and 64-bit operating system. So if you have a 32-bit operating system, then you are going to download this file with i586, and if you have this operating system with 64-bit operating system, 64-bit, then you are going to download this Java. How will you find what is your operating system version, right? You go to here, right click on my computer, and then you will get, for example, my computer is 64-bit operating system. So I'm going to download this, but before I download, make sure you accept their licensing agreement and you click on download. So once you have clicked on download, depending on if you are using Chrome or Firefox. If you are using Chrome, you will see it is on the lower left corner of your screen, it is being downloaded. And as I am using Firefox, I will have to click save. And once you can see that it is being saved, right? Pretty much whatever you download from internet, it will be, in most cases, it will be downloaded to your download folder. So how do you go to your download folder, right? So your download folder, if you are in this Windows Explorer, then if you can see downloads, right, you'll be able to see your download, like the file that I'm downloading. As you can see, 12 second, 11 second left, it will be downloaded here. So once that download will be completed, then this temporary file will be gone. So give it a little moment, and now it is fully downloaded. As you can see that the exe file is fully downloaded. Now I'm going to double click on it to install it. For some of you, you might have to right click and say run as administrator. So if you see an issue down installing it, you right click on it and select run as administrator. So I'm going to click run. Now I'm going to select next, and then I'm going to select next again. While this is going on, let me quickly see what is happening with my resolution. If I go to control panel, and if I go to display option, right, let me see if I what is my resolution at the moment. So change this to settings. I'm going to select, and this is the problem, I'm going to select this, right. Let me see how it looks like now. This, so while Java is being installed, right, let me pause that. I'll be selecting OK here, and then I'll click next. You will see that the big advertisement for Java, 3 billion devices run on Java. So this is a cool thing. So now it is saying that Java SE is installed. I'm going to close it. Now how will you make sure Java is installed, right? So close this command prompt and you go to command prompt again, right, and there you type Java, right. Can you see these options now? Previously it was Java is not recognized. Now you can see the Java options, right? So we are good here. Java is installed here. Next option. Next step in our installation process is to download Eclipse. So Eclipse is the IDE or integrated development environment that we are going to use to write code and execute it. So to download Eclipse, again you can type in your browser, you know, download Eclipse, you'll get link, but I have the link here. I'm going to go there and I'm going to download it from there. So bear with me a little bit. As you can see here, right, we can download Eclipse from here by, actually let me see which one I'm going to download. That is fine, you can download Symbol. And then I'm going to click download. Again, as I said, whatever you download, it will be downloaded under your downloads folder. Right, let me take a look what is happening in this case here. So it is asking me if download is not started to click here, so I'm going to click here. And then hopefully it will be started. So let me see what is happening. No, not downloaded yet. So I'm basically, I'll go to my Firefox browser and from there I'm going to download it. Yep. So it will take 10-15 seconds for the Eclipse to be downloaded. Once Eclipse will be fully downloaded, you will see that Eclipse will be appeared here, and then the next step will be you install Eclipse. How will you install Eclipse? Again, for some of you, you might have to right click and run as administrator, but I'll be directly double clicking on it and run. So I'm going to select Eclipse IDE for Java developers, and then I'm going to click install. Here I will click accept now, and then the installation process will be started. So give it a little moment so that it can continue with us. So I'm going to remember, accept, as you can see the Eclipse IDE is installed in my computer. Now I'm going to say launch, so it will bring Eclipse IDE for the first time. You will see Eclipse IDE here is being opened. So see here, it is asking for a workspace. Like, we need to select a workspace where we are going to save our script. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to browse, and let's say I have a folder where I'm going to save all of my script. You can have your folder as well. So let's say I'm going to go to my D drive, and then I have a folder called QA and inside QA I have a folder called Selenium, but you can save it. Let's say for the sake of simplicity, I'm going to save my script today inside the download folder, and that's it. This is my let's say this is my workspace. I'm going to launch Eclipse, and soon Eclipse will be there. We'll see Java code. So Eclipse IDE is now opened here. You will be clicking on the workbench, and then let's take a look. If you click like to open a new test, as I said, let me see the progress so far. So we have installed Java, we have installed Eclipse, right? These two steps are done. Let me mark them as green. Okay, so next step is run code, Java code, right? So now we have a IDE where we can write Java and execute it, right? So at this point, we have installed Java and Eclipse IDE, but we didn't bring any Selenium related file. So whatever we are going to write now, it will be code, Java code, nothing related to Selenium. Understand this, okay? Now I'm going to create a new Java project, right? New Java project. Let's say I'm going to name it as my first project. My first project. Okay. And then make sure that you have this Java 1.8 is selected here, and click next and finish. You have your project, right? Good job. Now if you go there, right, in src folder, that is where your code will be residing. Now if you right click on it, you will see that you will be able to create new. Now I'm going to create a package. Remember that what is package in Java? We are going to have detailed discussion, but for now, understand it in that way. Package, under package, you can get multiple things, right? When you go for a tour package, you might, you know, get hotel, you might get, you know, cruise, so different thing you can get. So under Java package, we will have class, interface, different kind of code. So that's why we are calling it as package, okay? I'm going to name it as my first package. Normally package name convention is put all of the, you know, lowercase letter, but I'm going to follow a little bit different convention. It doesn't matter at this point. So I'm going to say okay, finish. Okay, now I have my package here. Remember, under package we'll have class, different kind of Java code. So one of the thing that we are going to create here is we are going to create a Java class. So the name of our Java class, let's say again we have to put my first class. Okay, remember the naming convention that I'm following is camel case. What is camel case? If you look at my document, right, if you look at my document here, if you scroll down, you'll get a little bit explanation on what is camel case. Now, if you take a look, camel case, right? Camel case, C uppercase, C uppercase. So, this camel case has two types. Upper camel case, where every letter of each word will be uppercase without any space, as you can see, like this, right? And then we have lower camel case, where the first word will have a lowercase starting and the remaining word will have uppercase starting without any space. So these two type of camel case, right? So you always try to write your case name with upper camel case, okay? Upper camel case. It will not harm if you write it in any other way, like, you know, you put all lowercase, but do not put any space in between class name, okay? Here you go. Then you click finish. So, can you see? You have your first class here. First class, exactly. You have your first class, and this class is under my first page, right? Remember, this is a app in Java. Each line will be terminated by semicolon. So, if you see, there is a semicolon. That means this is a full statement, right? Then let's come to the class. For now, just do not worry about this public word, but remember this is a class, so there is a word class automatically appeared before it. And then you have, can you see this curly bracket? This is the starting point of the class and this is the ending point of the class. So whatever you are writing in between this curly bracket are part of class. That means this code will be belong to that class, right? So from here to here, whatever you write, it will be your class's property. Now, so this curly bracket is ending the class. Just remember this. This curly bracket is ending the class. Okay. Now, so our class started here, our class ended here, right? So this is your code editor. If you execute your code, to execute your code, this is the guy that is your friend, where you are going to click and it will help you to execute your code. What is execution of code? The execution of code is, let's say you have written some code here, right? Now you have to see what does this code do. What is the activity of this code, right? So whatever you are writing here, this is your code, and if you click execute, run, then this code will be executed and you will see output here in this area. So that is where is you will see your output. This is your solution explorer. Sometimes you will not see this solution explorer, but always you can go to window, and from window you can bring the solution explorer. This right hand side part, at the moment you can keep it closed, we do not need it. And this is like when you are writing code, doing modification, right? You always save it, and then you have other menu options. And then can you see the menu bar here? And this is the toolbar by using which you can do different tasks. Now we have a code, let's see what happens if you execute that code, right? Now can you see selection cannot be launched and there are no recent launches. Now it is saying that we cannot launch this code. So what we will have to do, right? So remember that if you have done other language, right, for core Java code has a starting point. So what is the starting point? What is the starting point for Java, right? Obviously it will be a class, right? It will be a class, but which class? In one of, like in your project, you might have multiple classes. You might have hundreds of classes. So which class, like when you click on, okay, execute, which class will be executed, right? This is a big question. The class that will be executed is the class which has this method, public static void main and then you have this, right? Public static void main, ignore this part. We'll have a lot of discussion about public static void main. For now, that is where, wherever, whichever class has this main function, that is where your execution is going to be started. And remember, it is always, whatever code you are going to write, if you are not installing, if you are not executing your code via testng, that is a part of like very useful feature in Selenium, your code will be started from main method, right? In Java, we call whatever it has this, you know, after the name it has this pair of parentheses, we call it method, right? Main method will always have, as a tester, whatever code you will be writing, main method will always have this string, right? Pass, right? Don't worry about this part, don't worry about this part, don't worry about this part. They are pretty much, you will see these are fixed, it will always appear, but we will have further discussion. Now, right, now, let's say you want to, you know, print something to this output window. To do that, your code is system dot out. Can you see this IntelliSense helping us writing the code? Dot println system dot out dot println, and then I'm going to say this. Now what I'm going to print, I'm going to print something in the output window, right? What do I need to print here? I'm going to say what I'm going to print. Let's say I'm going to print hello testing world, right? And remember, this is string. Whatever you want to print here, if it is like, if it is numeric, if it is not numeric, let's say it is alphanumeric, like it has letters, characters, you will have to put it inside double quotation to print it, right? Because these are string, string will be always inside double quotation. Now if you execute your code, let's take a look what happens, right? Now can you see it is giving us option to execute it, and at the end of the execution, can you see in the output window, which we are calling console, we are seeing hello testing one, right? So this is your first code, Java code. Hopefully you understood this so far, right? You can do something else, let's say hello testing world, and then you can say another thing. Let's say you want to you want to print something else, like you want to put a number 2080, hello testing world. So we are adding, we are putting this, right? We are putting this, and then at the end of it, can you see up to this is a string. I said previously that alphabet and special character are string, you will have to put it in the double quotation. But can you see this part is a numeric? So to numeric data, you do not have to put it in the quotation, and I'm adding that numeric data with that alphanumeric data, and it, you will see like how output will be looking at the moment. Now can you see hello testing world 2018? But let's say for now ignore this part at the moment. Okay, now the next part of the course. So the next part of the course is we will have to, our goal is to execute, write a test case that will be automating this test scenario. What is the test scenario does? It will go to newtools.demo.aut.com, and then it will input an incorrect username, and it will input an incorrect password or correct password, and then it will click on login. When you click on login, if your credential is incorrect, it will not be logged in. So we will make sure that we are still not logged in, and we are seeing the username text box. So that will be our verification today. This is a simple test case. You can see the step. First it's saying go to newtools.demo.aut.com, and then site loaded
input incorrect username, input incorrect password, click login, right? Login fields and username text box still displayed. That is our code. Now, by using Eclipse, if you want to execute Selenium WebDriver code, right, you need to download a set of jar files that we are calling Selenium libraries, right? So there are some very good people who wants to help you, who wants to help us. So they have written some code that we can call and it will do some job for us, right? They have written complex part in from their end, and they are regularly updating it so that we can keep using it. We do not need to worry about this. We just go to their site and download it and associate it with our project. That's it. And then we can call their whatever they have written, we can call it and can use it, right? So what are those code that is supporting Selenium and we can call and execute them, right? So if you look at my document here, you will see that in the subsequent part of the code I said you will have to go to this link to download this, you know, Selenium libraries for Java, right? So you can type it as well, download Selenium libraries for Java, but I'm going to go to their site to download it. So you can see that I'm in their site, and you will get a lot of helpful information in this site if you can read it. But for now, let's say I'm going to download this library for Selenium libraries for Java, and I'm going to save it. As usual, all of our download will be saved inside the all of our downloads will be saved inside this downloads folder. Now can you see Selenium Java 3.14.0? This is the Selenium library version at this point, as of 2018 October 3rd. Okay, now this is a zip file. I'm going to right click and I'm going to say extract to this. If you do not have this you know, extracting tool, you will see, look at your right button, you will see extract option. You will be extracting it by selecting one of the options here. So I'm going to extract this libraries, and can you see that is where my extracted libraries. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to associate these libraries with my project so that I can call Selenium, so that I can call Selenium libraries to manipulate the browser. Remember, if you want to manipulate your browser, if you want to automate your browser, you will have to use Selenium libraries. Otherwise, you will have to write your libraries. But we do not want to write our libraries. We are not that much expert, right? So we are going to use someone else's libraries. So how will you associate these libraries with your project, right? This is a very good question. So if you come here, my first project, this is your project name. You right click on that, and then can you see build path, right? You can see, right? Here in build path, click on configure build path, right? And then can you see libraries? You can see, right? I can see, at least I can see. So can you see add external jars? You click on it, and then where is it? Where is your jars located? Can you see this folder that you have downloaded? That is where. Now how will you select these jars? If you press control key from your keyboard, and then you can select each of these five at a time. So keep holding control key and then click on each of these .jar files and then click open. Now can you see two jar files added here? Now we need to add some more jar file. I'm going to click there again. Can you see this libs folder? I'm going to go inside that, and same way I'm going to hold control, or I'm going to hold shift and then hold shift key from the keyboard and click down arrow. Shift key from the keyboard and hold down arrow and click open. Now I'll say apply and close. So you will see all of these libraries are associated here. Now we can write Selenium code to automate the browser. That's straightforward it is. Okay. All right. So we are going to automate this as we have associated the libraries, right? So what we are going to do, we are going to go there. So our run core Java code and also associating these libraries are done. Now we are going to write test case to automate this. Write code to automate this test case. So according to the code, we need to go to this URL, right? We need to go to this URL using, let's say, we are going to use Chrome browser. So we are going to go to that URL, and then we are going to input here a user ID and then a password. Then we are going to click on sign in, and after sign in, you can see that our sign in is not successful. That means if we still see the username text box, that means, you know, our test case is passed, because for the invalid credential it should not allow us to be logged in, right? So we are good. So we are going to up to that much. Now remember, if you want to run your code using Chrome browser, remember you have to download Chrome driver. If you want to run your code using IE, then you have to download IE driver. If you want to run your code using Firefox, there is a default driver already given with, you know, with this. You do not have to download, but you can still download. So Firefox, Chrome, IE, wherever you want to run your code, you will have to have download corresponding driver. We are going to run our code using Chrome. So what we will have to do, we will have to download Chrome browser. How will you download Chrome browser? Let's say you say download Chrome browser, Chrome driver. Remember, it is not Chrome browser. We already have Chrome browser installed. In order to Selenium able to drive that Chrome browser, we need to download Chrome driver. Do not, you know, mess around with driver and browser. So we need to download Chrome driver. Okay, I'm going to download Chrome driver. Can you see download downloads Selenium web browser automation. So I'm going to select the first option, and as it is from Google, and I'm going to click here. As usual, when you see this, that means this is your, for Windows, this is your Chrome driver. This is for Mac, this is for Linux operating system. So as we are using Windows operating system, this will be our Chrome driver that we are going to download, right? Let's download it, and as usual, it will be going to where? It will be going to our download folder. So this is our download folder, and you will see that our Chrome driver is downloaded here. It is zipped again. I'm going to say unzip it. Now you will see that is where our Chrome driver is. Now this is the Chrome driver. Can you see Chrome driver.exe? And what is the path? This is your path. I'm going to copy this path. And what is the name of the file? This is the file it is going, you know, Selenium going to use to drive Chrome browser. Okay, now what I'm going to do here, let's say hello testing world. Okay, after this line we are going to write a line for Chrome. Okay, what is that line? We are going to write system dot set. You'll see it is appearing here, system dot set property. And what is the property? Now you need to give a key and a value. What will be your key? We want to run it using Chrome driver. So what is the key for Chrome driver? You are going to say web driver dot Chrome dot driver. Web driver dot Chrome dot driver. This is your key for Chrome browser. And what is your value? The value of this key, value will be the path of that. Remember, we have downloaded Chrome. We have downloaded Chrome driver, right? Inside that path, what is the name of this Chrome driver? Yeah, this is the name of this Chrome. going to take it. Okay, bear with me, guys. So if you go there, you put your driver here, and then as usual, end the line with a semicolon. This is your complete statement. Next, right? Now that you have set the property from your for your Chrome driver, where it is located, from where it is going to start, now you can declare a driver. So what is the statement for declaring a driver? Web driver. Now let's say I'm going to say my driver. I can give it any name: my driver, your driver, or her driver, his driver. Right? My driver equal to what? I'm going to say new driver, not old driver, right? New driver. New. What is the driver type? Chrome driver. Okay. And then you have to do this, and then you have to close this parenthesis, right? Still you will see there are errors here. So what you will have to do, you'll have to click on that error, and can you see import? Remember, we have these libraries, right? We have these libraries associated. So now from this library, it is going to import support for this Chrome driver, right? And we can still see that error. So I'm going to click on again. Now all the error gone, right? Now I have a driver by which I can bring a URL. So I'm going to use, if you take a look, right, I'm going to go to a URL using that my driver, right? How do you navigate to a URL? So you have this my driver now, my driver dot, right? My driver dot get, if you say, can you see string all? So here you need to provide your URL. So what is our URL according to the test case? This is our URL. This is our URL. I'm going to copy this URL. Copy, and I'm going to put it in our code. Right? This is our URL. Now if you execute your code, right, let me execute this code, you will see that it will be bringing a browser, it will be bringing a Chrome browser. At the moment I do not have any Chrome browser open here, but you will see it is opening a Chrome browser. Can you see it is opening a Chrome browser? Right now in Chrome browser, what is the website it is opening? newtoast.demoaut.com. and notice that this browser is appearing as, you know, smaller window, so it is not coming as in full window, right? So we have a statement that we can apply here to make this browser, when it is opening, we can make it full screen. How do you do that? Again, use the driver, my driver dot manage is a command that we are going to use. Manage dot, what we are going to manage, we are going to manage the window, and what is the management that we are going to do on that window? We are going to say maximize that window. Now if you execute the same code again, you will see, and before you maximize it, let's say I'm going to ask it, hey, wait a little bit, so that we can see the effect of the code. Thread dot, there is a, like if you want to wait, like before you do this, wait here so that, you know, everything is okay, right? So thread dot sleep, what is the sleep? If you put 3000, that means 3000 milliseconds, that will be 3000 seconds. Now you will see that it will complain. What is the complaint? We are writing an unsafe code, right? And unsafe code means there will be a, you learn try and catch block, but at this point, remember that if you see, if you hover on it, it says unhandled exception. We will just, can you see where the code is located inside that method? Here we are going to say throws exception. That will be taking care of that, right? Throws exception. Now we do not see that anymore. Now if we execute it again, you'll see that it will be opening the browser, and after opening it, it will maximize that browser, right? It will maximize that browser. Now how will you Can you see browser opened in minimal, like smaller window? Now it is bigger. Good, good. Up to that. Okay. Now I'm going to write, like, when the browser is open, how will I make sure it is the right browser, right? How will I make sure? So what I'm going to do, can you see, right click, I'm going to inspect here, right? I'm inspecting. How I'm going to inspect? Right click, inspect. Right click, inspect. Now if you go all the way up, right, inside the head of the browser, can you see title Mercury Tools, right? Welcome Mercury Tools, and that is the text that is appearing here, right? So if we see the browser title is Welcome Mercury Tools, then we can for sure we can say that the correct website is loaded. So what is that? What is the code? This is the code. Right, this is the code. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to ask the driver, right? My site is loaded, it is now maximized. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to say system dot out dot println, right? Println. I'm going to print something here. What is that? What I'm going to print, I do not know at this point, right? I'm going to say I'm going to print something here, and what is that? Now I am going to get that text, whatever is coming on top of the browser in the title bar, I'm going to get that. I'm going to show you how you can get it. So you will get that text by writing this code. This is your driver, right? My driver dot, if you type get title, can you see? That will bring that title that is displayed over there. And when you are bringing that title, you need to save it somewhere. Where do you need to save it? You need to save it, let's say str title. You are just giving a name equal to. Now it will complain, what is that str title, right? Or let's say, don't make it complicated, let's say title. What is that title? Now you'll have to say what type of, like we are saving, we are bringing something and saving it to the title. Now we'll have to say what is that title type. So there are different data types like string, integer, float, double. As a tester, we will learn them, but the value that is coming from the website, it is, you saw that it is alphanumeric. So we are going to say it will be string. So it is a container type. What is the container type? String. So the value that is coming is going to be stored here. Now if you put it here, right, if you put it here, this will be printed in the output window. Okay, now if you execute it again, you will see that it is opening the browser. Let me close this existing browser. It will be opening the browser and then it will be maximizing it, and then it will get the title from this top part of the screen, and then it will be printing it in the output. Now maximize it, right, maximize it, and then it will be printing it. As you can see here, right, Welcome Mercury Tools, it came from here. You can say, let's say title, we see that Welcome Mercury Tools, but we do not know what is that. So if you want to say something like, let's say this is the title, right? And then remember, in between, this is one part and this is another part. In between you will have to put a plus here. Probably, guys, it will be much simpler, easier after you watch a couple of more sessions, but try to do whatever I'm doing and keep following me. I'm going to bring a lot of things here. So now if you execute it again, let me close this browser. Let me close this browser and execute it again, and you will see that it will be printing that title with a, you know, label on the left hand side. Maximize it and then input, you know, get the title, and you will see there, right? Can you see? This is the title,
and after that it has printed whatever was that in that container. In that container we have saved something here and it printed here.
Okay,
hopefully you are good up to this. Next step is we are going to input a username in that text box. How we are going to do that? Again, you are going to right click here on that text box and then you inspect it. When you inspect it, guys, follow me. When again you are going to right click on it and you are going to inspect it, right? And then can you see this is a input text box in terms of web language, in terms of computer language. Text box in HTML we call it input, right? And can you see some attribute name? What is the name? Username. Remember that attribute name, username. This input has an attribute named name, and the value of name is username, right? Understand this. So when you say, okay, this is David's father, right? This is David's father. So how we are identifying David's father? We are saying, okay, this is David's father. So here this input, you know, text box for whom, who has name equal to username. Got it? So I'm going to write a code that will be handling that. So follow me here. So what I'm going to do, my driver is my driver, right? Dot, and then I have a code find element, right? Can you see? Double click on it. Find element by. Now by what? By dot. Find element by dot what? By dot name. Remember, we saw their name, and then put pair of parentheses. And what is that name? The name is, you go there to the website, you copy this name. So can you see I'm identifying that input type by name, and what is the value of this name? This is the value of this name. I'm going to go there and I'm going to put it here, and on that one we want to set something, right? We want to send, like if you want to send a text box, if you want to type a text box, you will have to use this function, send keys. And what is this send keys that you want to put there? I close the, you know, statement, but that is what you want to put there. You want to put, what is the username that we want to input according to the test case? We want to input any username. Let's say we want to input O2 user. Okay, you got it. So can you see now it is showing that you will have to, you know, by cannot be resolved. So to resolve by, again we have these libraries. We are going to take help from there. We are going to click on here and then we are going to say import by. Remember, whatever you are importing, it is coming here, right? Remember that. We'll have further discussion on it. Now, next step is we are going to input the password. Remember, we have another text box here. This is password. I'm going to inspect this one as well. And if you inspect it, can you see this is again input? And what is the name of this input? Password. Right? Can you see what is the name of this input? Password. So I'm going to go there and I'm going to say my driver dot find element by. And what is that by dot again name? And what is that name? I'm going to click, and what is that name? The name is this password. And what do I want to do with this? I want to send another keys there. And what is that key? The key is I want to send a password here. What is the password that I want to input here? Let's say P123, whatever you like, right? Next, our next option is to click on this sign in button or link. Again, I'm going to inspect it. And can you see, guys, here again, this sign in has a name. What is that name? What is that name? Login. What is that name? Login. So again, I'm going to follow the same pattern. I'm going to say here my driver dot find element
by, what is that by? By dot, again name, right? And then what is the name of this object that I want to identify? This, and what I want to do, I want to click on that, right? I want to click on that, that's it. And finally according, if I click on it, right, let's do a quick execution on this, whatever we have written so far. So if I execute it, you will see that it will be opening the browser. After opening it, it will be maximizing it. After maximizing it, it is going to print the title in the output. After printing the title, it is going to be inputting the username, right? At this point, it is maximizing it. After can you see auto user, and it input the username and click on sign in. Now sign in will not be successful, we know that, because our username and password is incorrect. So now our task, verify if this username is still there. If this username is still there, if the username is still there, that means we are not logged in. That's why the username is there, right? So how will you verify if the username is there, right? How will you verify? So if you identify, if you again inspect this username, right, you will see it has the same description, right? Let me do it again. Inspect. Can you see name, username, right? So that means this is the object. This is the object, this username. This is the object that is, if we see this object still there in the screen, that means our login in is not successful and our test case is passed, right? If the website do not allow us to log in by the bad credential, then the website is good. If we can log in by any credential that is bad, then there is a problem in the website, right? So if it is refusing the login for the bad user ID and password, then our test case is passed. So we are going to write a if condition here. We are going to learn a lot of things about if condition, but for now, do whatever I'm doing, and that's it. So if I'm going to put a set of parentheses, and then I'm going to put a curly bracket, my if started here, right? And if ended here. So what is this? This is my if ending, right? If you put your cursor here, you will see that it is pointing out here. If you put your cursor here, it will say that it is pointing here. So what is that? This is ending main. Okay, now remember, whatever you do in that way, right, can you see double slash, and then if whatever you write, this is a comment means it will not be executed, it will be ignored. When you keep execute, it will, this comment part will be ignored. Okay, now if what is that, if this username text box is displayed, right, we are saying if this username still displayed, and if you write it in computer Java language, that is what it will be. If this username is still displayed, then we are going to say that, how do you say here, system.out.println, println. What do you want to say here? I want to say that my test case passed. My login is refused, right? Test case passed, right? Now, if I can see that username text box still displayed, that is, that I'm comparing it here, then I'm saying the test case passed, right? What will happen otherwise? Let's say I'm going to say else, right? Else means if you do not see that text box, right? Now you write something here. Else, I'm going to say something else. What is that? System.out.println, right? System.out.println. What do I want to do here? I want to do this. I want to do this. What is that? Test case. Okay. Make sense, guys? That's it. So if I execute it again, let me close all of this browser and let me click on play, and be printing that hello testing world message, and then it will be opening the Chrome browser, because we have wanted to do that. And after opening the Chrome browser, it is going to maximize it. After maximizing it, it is going to input the username, and it is going to input the password, sign in, and then it is going to check if username is still there. If username is still there, that is the true case here. It should say test case passed. Now can you see test case passed? Makes sense. Test case passed. Now, so that is what we wanted to do up to that. So our test case is automated, right, up to this. Now let's say finally when you are done with your automation, right, what you need to do or what you want to do, let's say you want to close your browser. So what you do, my driver dot am I making any spelling mistake? My driver. Okay, let me see. My driver dot close. Right? There is a path liner. So if you write it, let me see what is the message it is giving. My driver. Let me copy this code. I'm making a mistake here. My driver. Oh, actually, I'm writing out of. Right, out of the main function. Everything I will have to write will be inside the main function, remember, right, inside the main function. Now if you do it and close that statement, now if you execute it, after doing everything, it will be closing browser. Now at this point, can you see I have to automatically manually close the browser. Now if you do it, right, if you do it, the browser will be automatically closed. You'll see that after doing all of this execution, the browser will be automatically closed. So it will now maximize the browser, input username, sign in, and test case pass, execution done, right, quickly everything done. That is the magic of automation. You do automation, you learn automation, whatever automation, manual testers, whatever they will be doing, you will be doing 100 times faster than their work. One manual tester, whatever they are doing, right, you will be doing by your automation code, probably you will be one manual tester times 100. So hopefully this lesson was helpful for you guys, right? So there will be more interesting video coming up in the future. So keep following me, and thank you again for watching. It was a long video, 1 hour long video. Hopefully it will be helpful for you.